51-year-old Dean Hargett is not your typical cyclist. Every week, he racks up more than 100 miles. His biking is good for heart health, but not necessarily for bone health. Hargett discovered he had low bone density.
It alarmed me. I don't want to have fragile bones. I want to be able to be, you know, strong and healthy throughout the rest of my life.
A decrease in bone density could lead to osteoporosis, in which the bones become brittle and fragile.
About 1 in 4 men will have an osteoporotic-related fracture in their lifetime.
Looks good to me.
Over 12 months, University of Missouri researcher Pam Hinton studied how resistance and jump training exercises affected bone health for men ages 25 to 60. And the results showed these specific exercises did more than just slow the rate of bone loss.
We actually saw an increase in bone mass with either type of exercise, so that was a very encouraging and exciting result.
These exercises worked by decreasing the level of sclerostin, a protein that slows bone growth, while increasing the IGF-1 hormone that promotes growth. Now, Hargett knows that cycling and swimming are not enough to strengthen his bones.
Don't take your bone strength for granted. They can wither just like any other part of your body. Use it or lose it.
That's why weightlifting is now a regular part of his exercise routine. From the University of Missouri, Kent Faddis reporting.